Blessings on your Scorpio moon, my love. I hope that this message reaches your heart as it reaches mine, and I receive it through my own body, mind, soul with the help of this energy of the moon. When I first started tracking the lunar cycle about 4.5 years ago as a spiritual practice, an encouragement to get to know my emotional being, I noticed that on the days of the month that the moon would be in Scorpio, I would feel so chaotic within myself, very angry, easily reactive to things that people would say or do. So like my trigger was deeply on all the time. The whole point of following the lunar cycle for me was to really understand how the zodiac energies through the moon energy affects my body and my emotions and my mentality. Because I would read things from other teachers and astrologers and that made me feel things I couldn't explain. Like there was this resonance, if that's really the word that we're gonna talk or use with this. It's like this vibration inside my body, and sometimes I would feel it in different parts of my body. You know, sometimes my chest feels really like tight and warm, and like this feeling of just like this reverberation moving through my heart after I read something. That same thing happens when I listen to things as well, right? Or when I see an image. This is why Instagram's so amazing to me, is that we are using these quick bursts of image and word song, essentially, or videos as well, to inspire and to create sensations of love and joy and courage and hope for other people as well as ourselves. That's why I do everything that I do and continue to do, is to continuously inspire myself and remind myself of who I am. In relation to the world, I understand that we are all one, fundamentally, but on planet Earth, we need to learn this personal boundary. Like, who am I in relation to all of this? That's the whole human experience, waiting for your conscious desire to get to know who you really are. And that's through Scorpio Moon, I got in touch with my inner rage. Very on the surface calm, collected human being, but I have a dark side that has, you know, had a huge part in the wisdom that I'm able to access at this time in my life. 34 years old, and I've experienced many oceans and many waves and continue to persist, and I believe that there is a deep excavation that happens through grief and loss and trauma and the willingness to move on and to create our own path can be very, very painful. It's actually more painful than it is beautiful at the very beginning, but it's also part of learning to reestablish a relationship with pain, and that's another gift of my inner Scorpio. We are all Scorpio within. We have all lived in this body, in this being, for eons and eons and eons of time. We've just forgotten who we are. But no one can tell you what you are and who you are and where you are and what you're supposed to be doing and who is your twin flame. What does any of this mean to you? What does the Scorpio moon mean to you? This is why I'm even sharing this, is to try and give it the gift of exploring your own emotions and your own mind and your own body, just to do it, just because you are in this body and you deserve to get to know, why are you in pain all the time? Pain has been the thing that has led me into a deeper understanding of myself. The question of what is going on here, and what is this, and what am I really feeling, and where did this come from? Who is this associated with? How long have I been feeling this way? I love thought questions, right? Like learning to ask myself questions is how I have a relationship with my higher soul self. I ask out loud quite often. I speak to myself all the time out loud. I speak to myself all the time out loud, and I'm not going to call myself crazy. I'm trying to hear myself in a world that's trying to make you think that you need to be anything but yourself. There's nothing wrong with you. If you feel like you desire to be one thing, you don't have to change your entire being. You can be whoever you desire to be. And if you desire to change your whole being, that's your beautiful divine choice, and I love that. And expand into everything that you desire to do. Don't do it just because you're thinking that there's something wrong with you. Do it because you feel like you know this is right for you. You're the only one who knows what's right for you. I always hear, "What should I be doing?" But I don't know how. Can you tell me? Show me. We're here to show each other. I'm so glad that I've been able to share my journey. And this expansion through my Scorpio moon has taught me a lot about the attachments that I've had in my life. On that deeper level, Scorpio governing the lower abdominal part of our body and the sacral chakra, that deeper connection to the womb and the womb space, the energetic womb space that lives within every human being. You do not need to have a physical uterus to have a womb. You were born of the womb. You grew in that. You need to remember your origin, and that's another gift of Scorpio moon that's always coming back to the mother. Your proverbial mother, the real mother that you were actually born through. If you never knew her, if she gave you up, if she's been abusing you, if she still abuses you, if you think that you have an amazing relationship and you're still unaware of your codependency, if you're triggered by her pain, if you are sad for her, lonely for her, keeping yourself small for her. There is a line through Scorpio that is attached to your mother and your inner angst and rage and inability to move forward is also attached to her. There is a huge gift that you can offer yourself, and it's learning the concept of energetic cord cutting. This has been something that I've worked on for years, and it's something that you have to repetitively do as an energetic exercise. Just as you think about somebody that's hurt you, and you know, that entitlement that we feel that, like, why would I ever forgive somebody that did XYZ to me? Like, we hold on to that, and that's part of our healing through grief as well, right? When we hold on to the feeling constantly, like, I deserve to feel this way. And you do deserve to feel this way, but how long are you willing to hurt yourself and hold yourself back and keep yourself, like, oppressed and depressed by your own mental processes, the way that you think about this thing that happened to you? I'm learning to think different ways about my own trauma and loss and grief and disappointment, loneliness, the loneliness that I've felt my entire life as a child. Never knowing how to be safe in a world that doesn't offer much safety and comfort. You find pockets of it, but it's always short-lived, and the pain in others, you know, causes them to shut down and turn away from you. And there are reasons why we have to move on from relationships. There's reasons why we have to say no more, and it doesn't matter whether or not this person was your mother, father, brother, sister, lover, teacher, best friend from kindergarten, your twin, what the fuck ever. If you are dealing with somebody who continues to harm you and harm themselves and not offer you any sort of energy in response to your care and concern, you need to learn personal boundaries. And it's also a very painful thing. It's so painful. I learn about my pain through Scorpio moon. I learn about it and I feel it. I'm learning to feel the pain, just feeling it. Where do I feel it? where the dominant areas in my body that I feel congestion and pain and tension on a regular, and then completely ignore it and refuse to honor it. And whatever it is that I do to help me mediate that pain, and how I turn away from the pain constantly, whatever you're doing, whatever addictive pattern it is, can be turned into a practice of loving care. This body deserves loving care. This energetic core that I have with somebody that hurts me, that I continue to refine and anchor and strengthen every time that I go over my pain story in my body and my mind. But I learn to cut the energy as I sit with my pain story. Where do I feel this in my being, you know? And you feel it quite often around the heart, and I can touch my own heart and feel like into the solar plexus and around the gut. You know, a lot of the times there's just so much tension in here that like I can just feel, like I'm here, I can feel that this body is holding, and I desire to let go of this connection with this person. It doesn't mean that I don't ever have to see them or speak to them ever again, but I desire to let go of this anchored energy that's in my body, that's attached to the thought feeling of them. Yes, we are releasing the thought feelings from our bodies. We can still have connections with people without just pouring out our distrust and our distaste and our disappointment. I heal myself with my own resolve and acceptance of what is. I give myself time to be with how I actually feel and why I do feel the way that I feel, but I also give myself permission to move on from the story of what has hurt me. I am hurt, and I give myself my own love. Thank you to Louise Hay for that beautiful divine affirmation. I say that to myself all the time. My inner child, I give myself my own love. Thank you with the Scorpio moon. It's all about healing with that deeper ancestry, the water signs of Cancer and Scorpio and Pisces all bring with it this different energy of how deep your emotions really go, and your willingness to go into the depths of your own ancestry and know that your pain doesn't just belong to you. It's a collective collection of DNA through eons of time, multi-leveled tiers of time. My human life is this 34-year-old woman in this human body at this time, but my cellular consciousness that is a conglomeration of my father-mother DNA conglomeration. And then there is a mysterious soul path that is undeniable when you continue to self-inquire and learn to self-heal, that you know that you've been here for a long time and it doesn't quite make any sense. And no, I don't know where I'm really from, but I know that I'm here and I'm supposed to be here. And your feeling of homesickness is this gift as well, to know that, like, why would you even feel homesick if you weren't from somewhere else magically, from some other pattern in time. You're here now though, and you're learning to come home to yourself now. My Scorpio moon helps me build a bigger house for my emotional turmoil, that rageful ocean that's within me, that easily hooked and triggered by other people. That willingness to be the container for the ocean now is the strength of my Scorpio. Not just being triggered by the ego-based personality aspects of my inner Scorpio, but willing to just look at it all and be with it all and wash over it with the light of my new awareness. I'm willing to let go of this deeper embedded connection with this person for the greater good of us both. I release you. I forgive the energy between us. Forgiveness. I reclaim the energy from continuously needing to pour it out about how much you hurt me. It's okay now. And I don't need to see you ever again, and I don't need to speak to you ever again, but know that you're free and I'm free. And move on, and we both move on. And I can repeat this 1,000 times if I need to. Don't ever listen to the part of the ego mind that tells you I should be over this already. when you have loved someone with every ounce of your cellular being, your soulmates in all different forms, even your animals, it stays in you, it's embedded in you, it's part of you. I feel you even when you've left me, and even when you've left this earth, I feel you, and that's how I know that this is all real, and this is so meant to be, and that we are continuously being asked to uplift ourselves in spite of the pain, blame, shame, toxic mental story that we have inherited and are also consistently fed through the media. You need to learn to think for yourself and feel for yourself. The part of that means feeling exactly what you're feeling right now. And that's the gift of Scorpio through my Venus in Scorpio and my mother's sun sign is Scorpio, my willingness to explore what the archetype of Scorpio really means to me, getting to know my inner Scorpio moon. That is a spiritual practice in itself. And there are infinite resources to learn from on the internet. Googling keyword searches has been how I find everything. Like, what am I curious about? And I would type in Scorpio magic moon energy and then click search and then just explore what I would desire, like whatever came to me. I never look for anything without curiosity. That's just my nature. I am divinely Sun Sagittarius, December 16th, 1983, but I am so much more. I am Taurus Moon, Venus in Scorpio, Mars in Libra, Mercury in Capricorn, my rising sign is Capricorn. I love the mountain sea goat. Learning about all of the divine zodiac archetypes has truly been part of one of the biggest parts of my awakening, and this, the ability to speak so openly, has been an awakening within itself. It took years of intentional desire to get to know myself where I realized, like, I'm no longer afraid to speak, and I love what I'm speaking about, and I'm grateful, and it's meaningful to me. Part of the gift that I have to offer as well is, if you're seeking to learn more about who you are in this way, I have created and curated this amazing personal research astrology guide where you send me your birth chart information and I give you and send you back a personalized exploration tool for you to get to know all the aspects of your birth chart by researching it yourself. The stuff that I learned that were like, oh my god, the aha parts of my exploration I've curated into this gift for you. And the I ask for a donation to my cause, and if you're wanting to learn more about who I am and what I'm raising donations for, you can go to my website at www.boundariesarebeautiful.com and go to the community services page and just explore. And if there's anything that I can help you with, I'm here for you. I have so much desire to help us expand and love so that we can create a more cohesive truth to this earth that is awakening. This isn't any woo-woo bullshit. This is real and this is truth. And if you're willing to get to know your darkness and your pain and your ego with love and curiosity and compassion, your life will surely change, because mine has. And there has to be some gift through this that we are being offered at this time. So that's the gift, the faith and trust that this is something that can help anyone. If you believe that it resonates with you, I look forward to hearing from you. Blessings on your Scorpio moon. I love you.